All right. Good morning, then. Welcome to Microburst this morning. We're going to use the chair. We're going to use a little bit of the mat. We're going to use some of our body weight. The idea today is to take 15 minutes and to get us moving, to get us feeling good, and to get a little bit of energy built into the day, right? Okay. So we're going to start just behind the chair, and I'll go from the side. And all we're going to do is we're going to do a nice, easy sit back in the chair. So we'll push the chair forward as we sit our butt back. All right. So it should help keep us upright in that squat. All right. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. And let's go ahead and sit. 1. Good. And sit back. 2. So pushing that chair, or if you have the wall to hold on to. 3, 4. Allows us to just sit back a little bit more. 5, get those hips moving. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. So from here, still holding either wall, chair, and all we're going to do is add a knee tuck and push it back. So we don't need to come up to push it back. It's just knee tuck and push it back. We're just not touching. Here we go. 1, 2. Good. Just tuck the back. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Switch it up. Here we go. Other leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Excellent job. All right. So let's get back into our chair. Or if you don't want to do a chair, you can just do a straight squat. But if you're in the chair, we're going to sit up and we're going to extend forward. All right. So it's not so much a punch. A punch would mean we'd load from here. From here, we're going to stay here and we're just going to load. And here, if you're just doing it without the chair, it's just here and back up. It's almost like a lunge and a squat mixed together, right? So we're just right here. Let's go ahead and load up. 1, 2, just reaching forward. 3, 4, 5, 6. So we're not going very high up. 7 off the chair. 8, 9, 10. Let's go ahead and go the other direction. 1, 2, keep it nice and low. 3, 4, 5. Excellent job. 6, 7, 8. 2 more, 9, 10. Very good work. We're going to stay seated in that chair. So we're going to be nice and upright. And the idea here, we're going to turn the hands here. I want you to lock your feet still, lock your feet in place. Lock your knees in place. Whole bottom of the body is in place. Bring the arms up. All I want you to do is rotate across, rotate across. Now the idea is you're not twisting this way. These stay still. You're not going to go very far. That's okay. We're trying to get that thoracic spine rotation. 3, 2, 1. So reach those arms over here. Reach them over here. 2. You may get much farther than me. 3. 4. Something I'm working on. 5. 6. Almost trying to set your arms up on that on a table to your right. 9. And 10. Now extend the arms out. And all we're going to do is lift it back. Reach it forward. Lift it back, still keeping those legs planted. 2, this is all now. We're moving the trunk back and forth. 4, good, back. 5, and the chair is going to stop you. So when the chair stops you, the arms just go back. 6, 7, excellent. Keep it going. 8, very good. 9, 10, excellent. Let's go ahead and come out of that chair now. So from here, we want to get the legs moving a little bit more. So this leg is now going to go up top. All right. And all I want to do is push off the toe and back up. Push off the toe and back up. Okay. So we're starting to get into some of those step up variations. All right. 3, 2, 1 and up 1. And you can have your hands on the chair. 2. If you didn't have a chair, it would just be right there. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Excellent. Let's go ahead and switch it up. All right. Now, remember, the big thing here is we're getting into those calves a little bit. 1, pushing off that toe. You'll notice, 2, this foot on the chair. 3, stay still. 4, 5, 6, and I'm trying to use balance. You can obviously 7, hold on to the chair if you feel you need to. 8, I'm trying to test those legs out this morning. 9 and 10. Excellent job, guys. All right, so this next part you can do from the ground or you can do it from the chair. I'll leave it up to you. We're going to be going into some complexes. We've done these before, but we're going to do a push-up followed by a mountain climber. So leg in and out, I'll show you before we start to. Followed by some T-stabs. We're gonna do 10 all together, right and left, followed by some plank jacks, all right? So again, I'll walk you through all of these, so don't worry about missing any, or that what I just told you sounded like gibberish. That's okay, we'll get them together. Now, again, either from the ground or up on the chair. I'll show you the chair version here today. So we're up here, and all we're doing for that push-up is going straight down and back up. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, good, 5, 6, 7, we've got 3 more of these, down in, 8, 9, excellent job, guys. 10. All right. So now bring 1 foot forward, 1 foot back. 2 versions of mountain climbers I want you to look at. The first one is just step, 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 nice and easy. The second one is a quicker version. If you're doing the step, step, we're going to count out 10. If you're doing the quicker version, we're going to count out 20. You ready? 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Six, 7, 8, 9, 10. Keep it going. 12, 13, 15, 16, 18, 19, 20. Excellent work, guys. Excellent work. Okay, reset the mat underneath me. Plank jacks are next. Again, first version, step, step. Second version, open, close. 3, 2, 1, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Same count, 13, 10 for slower, 16, 20 for the quicker pace, 19, 20. I shouldn't say slower, I should say the modified version. It's just a little slower than the running version, if you will. Okay, I wanna try something with the arms. So this really depends a lot on your chair. If you have a really awkward chair to pick up, really heavy chair, maybe try something else that you can hold on to. It can be a box, it can be a trash can, it can be anything that you can hold in your hands just like this. The idea I want to do today is start to push movement with weight. All right, so all we're going to do is we're going to take a step forward, push this out in front, and bring it back. Catch that breath. Here we go. We're going right leg first, so step out with that right leg. Slight bend. I'm not looking for a drop lunge. Push it out. Bring it back in. Step with that left leg now. 2. Excellent. Alternate those legs. 3. Make sure you're breathing. 4, 5, 6. If you ever feel your lower back, 7, the weight that you're pushing out is too heavy. You're losing your abdominals. 8, So reduce the weight. 9, to see how my back stays flat. 10, I should be working more biceps, triceps here. 11, and working on some core muscles. 12, we've got 20 altogether of these. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Great job, guys. Great job. All right. Let's move to the mat. What I want to do here, these are hand walks. So a couple different ways you can do this. The idea that we want to do here is we want to walk our hands all the way out to the mat. If you struggle with this, I'll show you the first modification. You'll start on the knees, and you'll walk your hands all the way out to that like A position and back up to the knees. If you want to challenge yourself a little bit more, you'll start at the back of the mat, you'll walk, you'll bend the knees to get down if you need to, and then start to straighten them, walk it all the way out, and bring it back. All right, I know you guys are with me here. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. We got 8 of these. Here we go. Walk it all the way out. Get out there. Push the chair. Back up. Go ahead and stand in between each one. Let the blood rush less to the head. Good. 2. When you get way out there, make sure you're squeezing those abdominals. Everything's tight. 3. Coming back up. Tighten those abdominals. You guys got these. Halfway there on these. 4. Good. 5. 3 to go. Again, modify if you need, folks. 2 to go. 1 more for everybody. These are great. These are really good exercises to get the body moving. Also part of our movement prep series. There's 8. Good. Come down to the ground. We're going to continue to work on that core a little bit. I got 2 different versions for you guys. The first one is out and hold. If you want to add a challenge, we're going to add 4 shoulder taps in between. All right. So everybody starts on all 4s, hands under the shoulders. There we go. I wanted to say hands under the hips, but those are for the knees. Everything's parallel. Hands and knees are parallel with each other. And now extend your right foot, extend your right left foot, hold it. If you want to add 1, 2, 3, 4, bring them back. That's 1. We've got 8 of these too, folks. Come on. Good. Extend it out. 2, 3, 4. Excellent. If it's a struggle to hold that plank, hold as long as you can, then return to the knees. 4. Good. 5 to go. 4 to go. We're halfway there. Bring it down. Excellent work, folks. 3 left. 2 after this. Extend out. Extend out. Tap. 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 Last 1. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Excellent work. Let's flip it over. We're gonna hit the ground now running. All right, and I mean that literally. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna hands out to the side. We're gonna pull that belly to spine, squeeze those glutes. And all I wanna do is bring this foot up. Bring this foot. This foot can stay flat or up. If it's flat, it's going to be an extension. See how I'm putting them down every time? If it can be up without feeling that lower back, it's going to be those bicycle runs, okay? 3, 2, 1. You've got to have that belly to spine. Let's go. 2, 3, 4. Really pull that belly to spine. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. Hopefully you felt that all in the belly. Like I said, if you feel that in the back, that just means that you're arching instead of pulling that belly to spine. Let's go ahead and work those glutes. We're going to go single leg on this one. Hands either here. Here is a little bit tougher because we'll work on stability. All right, if your hands are at the side, we're going to pull that belly spine. Squeeze that glute up for me. 1. Come on. 2, 3, 4, 5. Last exercise here, guys. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Excellent work. Let's go ahead and flip it over. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. As always, finishing this cycle, I want you guys to make sure that you're always stretching, cooling down properly. Make sure we're stretching those major muscle groups. 9 and 10. Roll it up. Come up nice and slow for me. Excellent job today on that microburst, everybody. Have a wonderful Monday. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thanks for joining today.